Welcome, basketball fans, to Inside the Paint. I'm your host, Dani Klupenger. Coming up in this week's episode, we're going to get to know more about two freshman point guards. I sat down with Lady Vol Jordan Reynolds and the Vols starting point guard, Darius Thompson, to find out how they're embracing their roles on their team. Let's start off with Reynolds. Jordan Reynolds, a spunky 5'11" guard, has a passion for Tennessee basketball. And now, with only 3 games left in the regular season, the freshman truly knows how special it is to play in front of the fans in Thompson-Boling Arena.
It is fun. I mean, when the crowd gets into it, it's amazing. Like when we played Notre Dame, we played Kentucky, I think we played Arkansas when we were down, and then somebody hit a big shot and then we got up. It's awesome. Playing in front of all these people is just what I've really looked up to, and so now that I'm finally doing it, I'm just having a blast. It's awesome.
The freshman guard from Portland, Oregon has learned a lot since joining the Lady Vols, and her journey so far has come with some surprises.
A lot of surprises have been the difference in the tempo in the game. Like, getting up and down is way different than high school. Like, there's no, you know, shot clock in Oregon, so we never ran, and now it's just like, you have to run, you have to keep up, you have to keep up with the tempo, so that's a big surprise to me.
Reynolds also can attest to the competitiveness of the SEC, something she wasn't expecting.
I didn't expect it to be this tough for each game, you know, like, I remember watching some games before coming here and just seeing, like, who they played and just saw that they won, and I just figured, you know, oh, it's gonna be, you know, it's gonna be a walkthrough, but no, like, each game is intense, each game comes down to the wire sometimes, so I was very surprised by the competition in the SEC.
Coming in to play point guard for a nationally ranked team as a freshman is not an easy job, but Reynolds saw it as an opportunity to grow as a player.
Getting more comfortable in the point guard position, I thought it was important for me to, you know, be able to run the team and come in and just play with confidence, just as a point guard would do, so I thought I'd grown a lot.
With Ariel Massengale out of the lineup for Tennessee, Jordan Reynolds had no choice but to step up and be comfortable to run that point position to help out Andrea Carter.
Well, the first thing I thought was, oh crap, because, you know, this is our point guard. She plays 40 minutes a game. She's always in our face. She's always getting everyone together. She knows she's our floor general. And then I was thinking, you know, well, now it is my time. Me and Drea have to take over, you know. We have to fill in that spot because no one else can do it. So it was up to us. And I thought, you know, once she went down, like, it is kind of our time. Like, we need to take care of the ball. We need to run this point guard position.
Reynolds says it was the individual lessons with Coach Jolette Law that prepared her for the ball pressure she would face as a point guard in the Southeastern Conference. And she also credits the male practice players for bringing it every day to help her and her team get better.
The guys are wonderful, you know. Like they say, practices should be harder than your games, and they actually really are. Like, they press, they're athletic, they get up all in your face, so they really do teach us a lot. I appreciate them a lot.
With the SEC tournament nearing and the stakes getting higher, Reynolds is confident that if her team continues to play to their potential, they will go far in the SEC tournament and beyond. Darius Thompson has started the last 7 games for the Vols, and now he's leading the hunt to reach the NCAA tournament. Tennessee native Darius Thompson has dreamt of playing for Tennessee his whole life. And now the 6'5" guard knows what it's like to sport the orange and white.
I mean, all my life I've just been watching Tennessee, just been wanting to be a part of it. Now I'm a part of it and just feels great to be out there. I just feel like a lot of things came faster than I thought it would. Like, the season's almost over now. I felt like just the other day we just started it. So yeah, the season's going by real fast. I feel like it's a lot tougher than I expected, man. From the beginning of the season, when we got to SEC play, the level of competition is a lot greater.
Thompson, a quiet, mellow-mannered character, was challenged to be more vocal, and he has seen himself grow in that area.
Getting out of my comfort zone, that's what the coaches tell me all the time, get out of my comfort zone, be more of a leader out there on the court. I guess since I'm a quiet person, just like telling people what to do at all times, and I just thought of it as like, I'm the youngest player, but I had to tell everybody else what to do. This is hard for me, but I'm getting a lot better at it.
Struggling to find his voice, Thompson recalls a matchup where all the pieces to his game fell into place.
I felt like the TSU game, Tennessee State, I played a pretty good game. And that's when I started feeling real comfortable out there and just got used to playing. I was just getting steals, getting assists. I was just having fun out there, basically.
Thompson shares the point position with a veteran, Antonio Barton. Thompson says he's learned a lot from his experienced teammate.
Antonio's been playing for 4 years at a good university. He came here, he helped me out, we pushed each other every day.
With still 5 games left in the regular season, Thompson will keep developing his game. He says his teammates continuously harp on him to pull the trigger more often in games.
They tell me pretty much every day they want me to shoot more, and then they tell me how, like when we're on fast break, I surprise them sometimes with the passes I do, but that's just how I play.
And Thompson plays with aggression on defense and with finesse on offense, a style that has earned him some valuable minutes and experience in his rookie season. 6 distinguished professors and leaders on campus were a part of the honorary coach program this week. The 4 for the Lady Vols games were Dr. Sally Hunter from the Department of Child and Family Studies, Dr. Michelle Brown from the Sociology Department, from the Human Resources Management Master's Program, Dr. Debbie Mackey, and the Associate Director of Undergrad Programs in the College of Business, Tammy Brown. Head Coach Holly Warlick left quite an impression on the group of honorary coaches for the Lady Vols.
I thought she was entertaining more than anything. Very welcoming, very personable, made us feel right at home.
It was amazing because I've had a lot of the players in class, and Holly was just relaxed and excited what we do and just all the hard work that's behind the program.
I think it's a fantastic experience. I think it's an important experience too, especially for a faculty member in sociology. We work with a number of athlete students, and I think I have a better picture of what that life is like and what an incredible program the University of Tennessee has.
She even introduced former Tennessee rower Sally Hunter to more behind-the-scenes information than what she already knew.
Well, I was an athlete here, so I was fairly familiar with the weekly schedule, but she did talk to us a lot about their travel, and that was a difference. Rowing doesn't do as much travel as basketball, so we got a chance to hear sort of how that affects their academics and how much she expects them to be in class anyway.
For the men's basketball game against Florida, the Director of Online Programs, Jennifer Gramling, and the Director of One-Stop Service Center, Darren Curry, were named the honorary coaches. Gramling and Curry were more than happy to be called into the program.
I was so excited. I'm a UT grad, and it's such an honor to work here now and to be able to come back and do this. I was very, very excited.
Just being so close to the floor and being so close to the players and just the coaches, just hearing their responses and reactions to everything was really exciting, just to be engaged in that.
The regular season is winding down for both teams, and this weekend, the men's basketball team will head to College Station to play Texas A&M on Saturday, February 22nd at 3 p.m. This game can be seen on ESPNU. And it's back-to-back road games for them as they head to play Mississippi State on Wednesday, February 26th at 8 p.m. on SEC TV. The Lady Vols play at Mizzou on Sunday, the 23rd at 2 p.m. The game will be carried on SEC TV. On Thursday, February 27th, the Lady Vols will look to seek revenge on LSU after losing to the Tigers at TBA earlier in the season. The game tips off at 9 p.m. and will be on CSS for all of you at home looking to watch the game. Live Pink and Bleed Orange was the theme of last Sunday's game for the Lady Vols against Kentucky. Check out this time lapse of the transformation of Thompson-Boling Arena. Thanks for tuning in to Inside the Paint. I'm Dani Klupenger, and I'll see you next week.